Welcome to Courtside, a discussion of the post-election litigation brought by Donald Trump. We are day 22 after the election, 3 weeks and 1 day. Every sentient being, even the turkeys, both the country and the birds, acknowledge that Donald Trump has lost. So that leaves Donald Trump, Rudy Giuliani, and Jenna Ellis. Even JSA Emily is waffling at this point. Certifications in the states in favor of Joe Biden continue to pour in. The litigation count stands at 1 out of 39 cases that Trump has won. One. Trump today lost 2 more lawsuits in Nevada and 1 in Pennsylvania. Now, there is one Pennsylvania decision tonight that is getting a bunch of attention in the right-wing blogosphere, where a state judge in Pennsylvania ordered the state to stop its certification proceedings. The challenge is that Pennsylvania wasn't permitted to pass a law more than a year ago that allowed mail-in ballots. This challenge is 100% irrelevant. So most people already realize that Pennsylvania certified its election results yesterday for Joe Biden with an 80,000 vote margin. This lawsuit tried to stop that, but it was way too late. And by the way, this is not the judge's fault. The Republicans didn't bring the lawsuit until more than a year after the procedure that they wanted to challenge, this mail-in ballot one, was adopted. And the law they're challenging also happens to be passed by a Republican legislature some years ago. Making matters worse, when the Republican legislature passed that law, they said it had to be challenged within 180 days of its enactment, which of course led the Trump folks to wait more than double that time before challenging it. That's going nowhere. Meanwhile, you might have remembered yesterday, Team Trump was all out there in the airwaves celebrating the fact that, quote, state legislative hearings were going to take place in Pennsylvania and other states today about the so-called fraud in the 2020 election. Donald Trump even said to his aides that he was going to go to those state legislative hearings in Pennsylvania, in Gettysburg. Well, the hearing didn't turn out to be in the Pennsylvania State House. It actually was at Wyndham's Hotel or Motel, which might remind you of Trump's promise about the Four Seasons earlier. And of course, no Donald Trump showed up. The speakers included Rudy Giuliani, who evidently still has a fondness for hotel rooms, and he tried so hard to muster up some evidence and came up with nada, a total embarrassment. At the end of this, there was nothing. And indeed, it's more than just saying nothing. I can do no better than to quote the words tonight of Tom Ridge, who was the former Republican governor of Pennsylvania, who was George W. Bush's first Department of Homeland Security cabinet secretary. Here's what he said, quote, "History will record the shameful irony that a president who lied to avoid military service staged a bogus event on the hallowed grounds of Gettysburg in a brazen attempt to undermine the republic for which scores of real patriots had fought and died to preserve since its founding." So as we go into Thanksgiving, I want to give thanks to people like Governor Ridge. I'm not a particularly political person. I've always believed there's a decency to the American system, a belief in equality, a commitment to the rule of law, a place that puts our shared community, not party, first. And I would be lying to you if I said the last 4 years didn't challenge that. They did, every damn day. But you all reached out. You spoke out. You marched, sometimes with funny hats, sometimes with the blood of patriots being spilled, sometimes marching through tear gas and batons. And people like Governor Ridge and Michael Steele and Bill Kristol and others who I never thought would be my team, well, over the last 4 years, I realized they were on my true team. It's over. Trump can't take it away. Our team has won. Happy Thanksgiving. Be strong. Be safe. Be careful. I will see you Friday.